Hello everyone. In our previous video, we have already discussed about Salmonella and Listeria monocytogenes. We are really happy to see the response, and therefore we are again here with another microorganism, that is Escherichia coli or E. coli. As discussed in the previous video, we are going to discuss all the relevant factors which affects this deadly microorganism growth, like what are the primary sources of the particular pathogen, what are the food sources, pathogenicity, contributing factors, atmosphere, spore or non-spore forming, temperature, pH, and water activity required for the growth of the pathogen. Before starting the video, I request you all to please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon so you will not miss any update in the future. E. coli. E. coli is also known as gut bacteria or gut worm. Most strains of E. coli are not harmful, but are part of the helpful bacterial flora in the human gut. However, some types can cause illness in humans, including diarrhea, abdominal pain, fever, and sometimes vomiting. E. coli 0157H7 is one of the strains and produces a toxin known as Shiga. It is one of the most powerful toxins, and it can cause an intestinal infection. Research shows that some 265,000 Shiga toxin producing E. coli STEC infections occurs each year in the United States. Around 36% of these are probably caused by E. coli. When a foodborne outbreak occurs, it usually involves a Shiga toxin producing E. coli. Primary source. When meat is processed, sometimes bacteria from the animal's intestines make their way into the meat. This happens more with ground meat because it comes from more than one animal. Untreated milk. You drink unpasteurized milk which hasn't been heated to kill bacteria. Food source. E. coli is easily spread to other persons by fecal contamination of water and of food, especially in raw meat, raw milk, and raw vegetables. Many outbreaks of diarrheal illness are spread this way. Moreover, person-to-person contact easily spreads the organism. Research shows that symptoms of infection with E. coli typically appear 3 to 4 days after being exposed to the bacteria. However, symptoms may appear as early as 24 hours or as late as 1 week later. Pathogenicity. Some other types of E. coli infections can lead to UTI, that is urinary tract infection, RT, that is respiratory illness, pneumonia, and other illness like meningitis. Most people recover within 6 to 8 days, but it can be life-threatening in infants and people with a weakened immune system. You can watch a video on how to boost immune system. Contributing factors. Tips are given below that can help prevent infection with E. coli. Cooking meat well, especially ground meat. Drinking pasteurized milk, apple juice, and cider rather than unpasteurized. Washing vegetables, especially leafy green ones. Ensuring that cutlery and crockery are thoroughly washed with warm, soapy water. Storing meat and non-meat food separately, and using separate cutlery boards, and following good hand hygiene practices. Atmosphere. Atmosphere required for E. coli is facultative. That means E. coli can grow and stay in both aerobic and anaerobic environment. spore, non-spore forming. Escherichia coli are non-spore forming. Temperature. Optimum growth temperature of E. coli is 37 degrees centigrade. Therefore, it is known as mesophiles. pH. Optimum pH of E. coli is 3.6, means it is more on acidic side. Water activity. Moisture content requires for the growth of E. coli are 20% to 30%. This is all brief about E. coli. We hope that this video is helpful for you to understand E. coli better. Kindly let us know in the comment box how useful this video is for you. We will bring next video on another pathogen and defining the same basic aspects. Thank you for watching this video.